Major portions of the world are in conflict, and some, in fact, are going to hell.
In his maiden speech before the UN, President Donald Trump delivered a blistering attack on nations he described as evil and grave dangers to the world.
If the righteous many do not confront the wicked few, then evil will triumph. When decent people and nations become bystanders to history, the forces of destruction only gather power and strength.
The president giving the more than 150 international delegations present an upfront look at his America First foreign policy.
As president of the United States, I will always put America first.
He reserved his boldest threat for North Korea, vowing in unequivocal terms to destroy the country if it threatens America's or its allies' security.
The United States has great strength and patience. But if it is forced to defend itself or its allies, we will have no choice but to totally destroy North Korea. Rocket Man is on a suicide mission for himself and for his regime.
For Iran, Trump described its government as murderous and reckless and appeared to signal that he will exit the Iranian nuclear deal.
The Iran deal was one of the worst and most one-sided transactions the United States has ever entered into. Frankly, that deal is an embarrassment to the United States, and I don't think you've heard the last of it, believe me.
Praising Mr. Trump's remarks was Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who said he had, quote, never heard a bolder or more courageous speech in three decades of experience with the UN. The president's address also taking aim on what he described as growing terrorist threats around the globe.
The United States and our allies are working together throughout the Middle East to crush the loser terrorists.
Beyond the threats, Trump's speech more clearly articulated the outlines of his foreign policy, including a drastic turn from a tenet of U.S. foreign policy for decades, that the U.S. will support democracy abroad.
This is the foundation for cooperation and success. Strong sovereign nations let diverse countries with different values, different cultures, and different dreams not just coexist, but work side by side on the basis of mutual respect.